Okay. Originally, the Disney movie Moana was not my favorite movie. However, what catches my eyes is the Islanders, Pacific Islanders' life mentioned in the movie is very similar to Taiwanese operations. And the similarity helped me to encourage me once to go find Google it. So I found they are all in the same under the same group called Austronesian. The term Austronesians actually translate to South Island in Latin and Greek. And the accurate term is Austronesian speaking people, that is, people whose language belong to Austronesian family. The term is based on the linguistic concept. There's no Australia or Australian. In the beginning, the core concept of Austronesian was language. And there's nothing about biology, and despite the fact there are some bloodline related together, and according to the some Hawaiian-based linguistics from Robert Blossom, he said the Austronesian languages has existed about 5,200 years. According to how many languages are there in the world, the South Islander have a lot occupy the largest area in the world, with people who live in Taiwan, Philippines, and Indian Ocean islands of South Asia and the Pacific Ocean. Taiwan has the highest diversity of origins in the languages and the highest diversity of South Island languages. There are two subgroups under the Austronesian category, and Taiwanese Austronesian is also Formosa, which includes all languages spoken in Taiwan. And because of the diverse language, Taiwan become a key of puzzle to of knowing early human migration between Asia and other Pacific Islands. And the other subgroup is Malay Polynesian. And this group contains 1,200 languages, and this group is outside of Taiwan, except Taiwan. Other languages are included in this family. Archaeologist Peter Bellwood and linguist Robert Blossom first started intro intro first put Taiwan into the Austronesian language department. The linguistic and genetic trend of Austronesian tend to be very complex. Austronesian origins from Taiwan was very popular in the beginning. However, with more evidence was found, Taiwan is one of the five hypotheses now. And more evidence was found that relationship between Taiwan and other groups, such as Philippines and Taiwanese, and or New Zealand with Taiwanese, they all have been proved they have relationship, they have relations. So there are 7 billion peoples in the world, and there are almost 7,000 languages are used around the world. Taiwan is not very big. It's only 1,000 square mile bigger than Maryland. However, there are 30 languages spoken in this small island, and 30 languages that in the 30 in this 30 language, 23 of them are Aboriginal dialects, and they only make up 2.4% of the population in Taiwan. And these 23 languages are similar to another 1,200 Polynesian languages in Pacific Oceans. And these Pacific Ocean people includes 386 million people. And this bigger picture of human migration is shown by the close relationship between Taiwanese, Austronesian, and Malay Polynesians. Taiwan is like a bridge between Asia and America in many ways. For example, look at the famous Brooklyn Bridge. It connects New York and Brooklyn together. So it makes New York prosperity greater. It brings people together, connect people together. Taiwan is very special land that connects many people group together. We don't know why, what made these early voyagers leave Taiwan, but their migration created 1,200 languages and cultures in the Pacific Oceans. They opened the door to moving southward, and they left a trail to early human migration. Just think of it this way: no matter what they are in those islands, either Hawaiian or Australian, They are all the same, and that's what brings us together. How many?
Exactly 5 minutes.
You jump something. How's it possible?
Yeah, last time you were like racing and could barely get it all, and this time you talked much slower and it was faster, so I don't know. But it's fine.
You did good.
You did really good.
Yeah.
Did you try to stop the recording now?
Oh, yes.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear.
You can cut out the end.